since they got engaged, three Olympics have happened. The president changed twice. I think Pluto was still a planet. When they got engaged, I didn't even have kids. I got a third on the way.
In the early dawn of happiness, you gave me three kisses so that I would wake up to this moment of love. I tried to remember in my heart what I dreamt about during the night before I became aware of this morning of life. I found my dreams, but the moon took me away. It lifted me up to the firmament and suspended me there. I saw how my heart had fallen on your path. Singing a song. First of all, I would like to offer you all a very warm welcome to Chateau Chalin. We're gathered here today to witness the marriage of Geoffrey and Julie, to share their joy and celebrate their love. And as Geoffrey and Julie come before you here today as two, they will leave this place as one, united in marriage.
I want to thank both the Chang and Castellano family for traveling so far to witness the joining of our family through this marriage. Thank you to Julie and Geoffrey's incredible friends who are here to help us celebrate this three-day wedding extravaganza.
What a crazy time it is in the world now, all right? Pandemic is going, inflation is ravaging the economy, gas prices is through the roof. Prince Harry is not talking to Prince William, BTS is breaking up. Julie and Geoffrey got married. I can't believe we're here and this finally happened. Some of you almost didn't make it.
Kids, being the little sister to Jeff seemed like such a big difference. The 6.5 years between us seemed to me that he was the cool older one, capable of magic, and I sadly and jealously was not. Perhaps that is still true because it only seems right that today my brother and his now wife, Julie, would have this super cool dream wedding in this magical chateau in France for all of their friends and family. Although it might have caused some stress of them getting here and getting us all here and all of their stuff, maybe might not have made it, but it's just another example of the many crazy adventures that Julie and my brother can make it through together and still create something magical.
they have this WhatsApp chat that everyone here is on here. And I thought, oh, well, that's such a great idea for prep. All right. Everyone's sending songs. I'm like, oh yeah, yeah, I like to dance to this song and that song. They're sending those things. And then I get the text and they're saying, hey, I almost missed my flight because I need to find a COVID test at the airport. And I just did this. I'm like, oh snap, what are we getting ourselves into? And then someone else sends a picture. Look, this is what it looks like outside waiting for customs. I'm like, oh my God. Dress codes, train strikes, 6-hour lines at the airport, testing at the airport. I was stressed. I'm like, all right, the next message I see, I don't want to see this text. It's crazy. But we're here. We're here. We're here. And we all made it.
Just wanted to know we love you all, and we're so happy that you all had a chance to get to know each other.
Do you, Jeffrey, offer yourself wholly and joyfully? And do you choose Julie as the person with whom you will share your life in laughter and in tears, in conflict and tranquility, loving what you know of her and trusting what you do not yet know?
I do.
Do you, Julie, offer yourself wholly and joyfully? And do you choose Jeffrey as the person with whom you will share your life in laughter and in tears, in conflict and tranquility, loving what you know of him and trusting what you do not yet know?
I do.
And will you, the families and friends of Jeffrey and Julie, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
I do.
Yeah, you will. Good.
I remember when I first met Jeffrey. My sister had finally agreed to let me meet him. When I finally got to the bar/restaurant, my sister basically only let me talk to him for a few minutes and then shooed me away.
actually, I remember when I met Jeffrey, Julian and I had gotten into a fight. And then I drove to go meet Julie so I could talk to her. And there he was, this mythical creature. I'm like, oh my God, is he real? This is Jeffrey.
Julie has always been very private about her personal life. So as I got more chances to get to know Jeffrey, it was really exciting. Through seeing him at events with my cousins, then at family gatherings, and then connecting on social media and finally getting his cell phone so I could text him myself, I realized this person means a lot to Julie.
I know it might sound cheesy, but Jeff has always created magic for me, even if at times it came at my own expense. Whether it be him finding a way to walk through the wall of his childhood closet while laughing at little me and then appearing on the other side where I was watching in awe, fully convinced that the only explanation was that my brother must be an evil wizard, or finding a way to make his socks come alive to talk to me on long road trips while he was sleeping, or just creating something new and magical for us out of a basic tuna fish sandwich, which is still my favorite sandwich that he made. He has always found a way to make what seemed impossible to me possible. Some of these things might sound strange to you all, but to me, they really are magical.
These things don't just happen in a moment, they happen over time. And Jeff wasn't just this perfect person with no flaws. I believe that Jeffrey has truly grown into the best version of himself now when he met and fell in love with Julie. Her quirkiness, her naggingness to always be right, and her ability to have in-depth conversations all while playing Catan on her phone have made her the most endearing and wonderful friend and sister-in-law.
Julie, you're the crazy little sister I've always wanted. Just kidding. I'm happy you found your soulmate. In the midst of all this craziness in the world, you two are the perfect balance to each other's chaos. You both make it work. I love you guys. Jeffrey, you're an awesome brother. We even fight like brothers. Thank you for keeping Julie in check.
To be honest, I think the perfect word to encompass my relationship with Jeffrey is evolution. And to be honest, it has evolved from one where the older brother has to assess the 15-year-old kid who's dating his sister in high school to something that I consider to be a true, true brotherhood. Now, we speak almost every day. We know the inner workings of each other's lives and often find ourselves joking that maybe we should live together and forget about Alyssa and Juliet, and we could just chat about music and movies and just see the world. So honestly, maybe Jeffrey is my true soulmate after all.
My daughters, Jessie and Julianne, adore Uncle Jeffrey, and we're really fortunate to be able to see Julie and Jeffrey often. So it's really hard to remember what life was like without him.
We know that you're all happy to be here in order to witness and celebrate their union and to support them in sustaining it from this day on. We celebrate this unique time in their lives and make it meaningful by entering into it in an attitude of respect for their deep commitment to one another.
But that relationship that I told you about was one that I thought I'd lost and that I would never get back again. When I was 20, my own brother passed away very suddenly. It was a relationship that was really important to me. The hardest part of it was that brotherly affection, that brotherhood that I had once always had in my life was gone. But then there was Jeff. And thanks to him and his kindness, his compassion, and his goofiness, I have another big brother to look up to. And I value that friendship and that brotherhood that I have with Jeff more than I think he really knows. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, "I love you," out loud, at least once a day. It's a common search for the good and the beautiful in each other. And it's doing things for each other, not in an attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in a spirit of joy. It's never going to sleep angry. It's not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have the wings of an angel. And it's not looking for perfection in each other. It's cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It's having the capacity to forgive and not to bring it up later. It's speaking words of appreciation
and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. And it's giving each other an atmosphere in which each of you can grow. It's not only marrying the right partner, it's being the right partner.
Mei-Mei, I'm so happy that you found your person. One who accepts you for you, appreciates your fierce loyalty, compliments you in many ways, and allows you to be your extra self. I know Jeffrey will take good care of you, and together you will tackle any obstacles life brings you. I'm so grateful that Julie has found someone like Jeffrey to take on the world together.
Julie, when I met you, you are already an amazing woman, beautiful and strong, and I wanted more. While we dated, you were full of energy, vivacious, and carefree, and I wanted more. When we became engaged, I met new sides of you, your family, your friends, and I wanted more. When you became my best friend, I learned to understand you and the changes that occur when we grow together. And I still want more. I can't think of anything I want more. We've overcome the odds to be standing here together. The person I was before wouldn't recognize how good my life has been or how good it could be. And they wouldn't understand the shape and the form of the peace that you would give me. You've given me unbelievable frustration and unbelievable joy, and I wouldn't have it any other way. I vow to support you through every challenge, every adventure, every failure, and every experience. And I love you. And I will always want more.
Dearest Jeffrey, you are my best friend and the person who builds a little home with me, for me, and by my side. Together we grew, we stretched beyond our imagination, we learned, we taught one another, and even created a little world for ourselves. And how many times have we laughed and smiled over the thought of growing older, growing smaller, and growing wiser? So often you paint in words a visual of us holding hands as we hobble down the street together, or of us sharing an ice cream cone with the backdrop of a sunrise as we sit wrinkled in wisdom and so happy in our old and older age. There's a future out there after today, after right now, that I can't wait to explore and live out with you. I promise you that I will. And I, Julie Chang, vow that I'll love and cherish you and our marriage for the rest of our days. I promise. I love you, and I do.
Thank you.
Jeffrey and Julie have had the most special place in my heart. I can't possibly encapsulate all the love and all the feelings that I have for them in one speech, but all I have to say instead is I love you both dearly. And I love this event that you have created and crafted for us to be able to sit here and gush about how incredible you all are. Cheers, the incredible two individuals that we are all here to celebrate, to Jeffrey and Julie.
We love you so much. May your life as a married couple be as romantic as getting married at a chateau in France. May your life be filled with some of your favorite things, such as unlimited sugar-free Red Bull and hot and sour soup. And may your closets be filled with hair gel, hats, and long, extravagant formal wedding wear, dresses. Please raise your glasses and help me cheer Julie and Jeffrey on their special day. In addition, our family has had the opportunity to meet and hang out with Jeffrey's family through several occasions, including family gatherings, and they are a wonderful bunch of people, ones we are proud to call family.
Thank you.
about it. It might explain why now myself as a grown 30-year-old woman is so scared of so many things and such a big baby that he always calls me. And I'm gonna blame you because you scared me my whole life and did these weird things like walking through walls that seemed impossible. And then I grew up to like believe everything. It's all your fault. Since marrying my husband, Taylor, it seems I have only made it worse because now they both team up together to always laugh at my expense. But what now I have on my side, and I'm so happy, is a sister, Julie. As we all know, and as Jeff has learned to know too, Julie is the true one capable of magic. As adults and as we have grown, I am lucky to call my brother and Julie two of my very best friends. And I've realized as we have spent time together that with Julie by my side, the one with the true power, as long as she's looking up from her phone, the one who is never wrong, or so she believes, we can finally take on evil Jeff and his powers for good.
Let's raise our glass, everyone, and cheers to perfect love in a crazy world.
Hope you take this last night to enjoy some dinner, have a good time.
And have a toast to Jeffrey and Julie. May you always keep your magical adventures alive.
I, Jeffrey, take you, Julie, as my wife, and I promise to be always faithful in joy and in pain, in sickness and in health, and to love you and to honor you every day of my life.
Take a look. And you, I, Julie, take you, Jeffrey, as my husband, and I promise to be always faithful in joy and in pain, in health and in illness, and to love you and to honor you every day of my life.
Traveling in the world of my creation, what we'll see.
I could not be happier that my brother has found real magic and love in such a generous, kind, and sometimes, whether she is trying to be or not, hilarious person. I have to truly thank Julie for coming into our lives. I have seen firsthand how happy she makes my brother.
And anything you want to do it, wanna change the world, there's nothing to it. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it, and anything you want to do. There's nothing to it.
The two of you together are truly wonderful, and I love you both, and thank you for being such a big part of our lives. I know as you take on the many more adventures of the world with one another, you will only grow in your love. Don't forget to keep laughing and exploring the wonders of the impossible together, because together you are capable of real magic.
Everyone, in the presence of families, friends, and before everyone here today, Jeffrey and Julie have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. It now gives me great pleasure to declare that you are husband and wife together. Congratulations. And now finally, Jeffrey, the moment you've all been waiting for, you may kiss the bride.